Well, this is the Boris N, the Elbe River lawn. And in May 1945, May 8th, the war ended. And so Ugo had time to write, and he wrote this letter to his first girlfriend. As I write, I find it difficult to realize that I'm not censored. Words just won't come now. I've been tongue-tied so long. Perhaps if you write me questions, I'll loosen up a bit, okay? I'm still in the 29th doing occupation work in Bremen. My work for some time revolved about division traffic system. After all, I am a copper. Isn't that a gag? Training with the infantry in England was tougher than combat. Of course, they taught us commando tactics, but they never suggested a real enemy. He makes all the difference. I used to be a doggy with a BAR. That's a Browning automatic rifle. I assure you I would have been dead by now if, as I write you, once while in England, I was expecting a change for the better. He was made into an MP by a fluke. Otherwise, he would have gone in with the 175th with the Browning automatic rifle, and their life expectancy was 10 minutes in battle. I didn't realize how much better until shortly after D-Day. I haven't killed anybody yet. I don't think so. Most of the real killing is done by artillery. I've been so terrified as to forget eating for days at a time. Once in Brest, France, a shell landed 4 yards in back of me, 4 feet to be exact. I measured it the next day. It was a dud, or I wouldn't be writing about it. On D+4, I was in a field with the Rangers. Jerry bombed and strafed us. A few of the boys were replaced by craters, approximately 10 feet from me. I didn't display any heroics until it was absolutely necessary, and it was on D-Day. I spotted a half a dozen mines, and by lying down parallel to them, I cautioned the infantry as they approached. The doggies used to be in back of me in those first days. I shouted at them, but one guy didn't hear, and I saw him sink a few yards from me. His legs were only pieces of wet flesh and clothes. The blast was only one of many. Renee, I'm safe now. You don't mind if I talk a bit? That's enough for a while. Yes, one war is enough, and sooner or later, one's number comes. For as far as I could see along the water's edge, there were bodies. Hundreds, hundreds dead. I didn't believe it then. I still can't quite grasp it. How did I come through it without a scratch? This is a terrible letter. There were a lot of funny incidents too. I'll tell you all someday. Good night and love always.